So this is the tobacco roots. No, it's not. This is the Ellen Wille Hair Society collection. This wig is called Charisma, and it is tobacco rooted, is the shade that I am wearing. It is fully hand tied. It has a monofilament top. It has an extended lace front. It has silicone ear tabs. It is adjustable. It conforms to the shape of your head. I don't even know what else to say. It's phenomenal. It is amazing, and as soon as it launches, guys, if this is a style you like, I absolutely recommend it. It is just so, so good. Hi guys, it is Michelle and I am here today and I am super, super excited. I'm actually here today to do a wig review for you guys. And yeah, so this should be the first of many to come. So I hope this is good for you all. I'm getting all tongue-tied, I'm so excited! Okay, so I want to say a super duper big massive thank you to Ellen Wille US, in particular to the amazing and gorgeous Erin Fortune, who, her and Robert Stapleton, the two of you, and your whole team are just phenomenal. So yes, you guys know I'm Scottish, I do not live in the US, I live in the world though, I'm in Scotland. So basically I had just irritated Ellen Wille US by sending pictures via Facebook, and I'm like, oh, check this, look at this wig, I love it, it's so amazing, with a photo of me wearing a wig that I liked that was obviously Ellen Wille. And the brow power I had used, and I was like, yeah guys, that's amazing. So I ended up a bit of a conversation, and they said, would you try a couple of products for us? And I was like, yeah, of course I will, that's fine. So basically last week I got this package of three wigs. Oh my goodness, I was kind of blown away. And I was crying, I was so happy, I was shaking. And anyway, so basically today, first of all, I am wanting to do a review of this amazing wig that I'm wearing. So, it's gorgeous. This wig is one of the new Hair Society collection, which will be launched in the US as of May this year, 2017, I believe. The wig that I am actually wearing, I mean, even look at the box. The box it comes in is even really kind of luxurious, really beautiful. So Hair Society. Now, this collection really is intended for people with complete hair loss, like my wee bald self. Now, the wig that I'm actually wearing is the Ellen Wille Hair Society Charisma. So the shade that I am wearing of this Hair Society Charisma is a tobacco coat long rooted. So before I show you this wig, what I do want to talk to you about is their cap construction, which I'm obviously going to whip this off and show you. So this wig, as you can see, I mean, look at how natural that is here, the parting. You can kind of part it anywhere, like totally anywhere on this wig. So this wig, it has a monofilament top, and guys, it's monofilament top. It has a fully hand tied cap as well. That is incredible. I love the fully hand tied cap. I love monofilament tops. And what else could we have just to make it even more super duper amazing? It has a lace front. It doesn't just have a lace front, it has an extended lace front. So let me show you. If I pull that back like so, what I could do is kind of pin that up. Obviously, you can tie this back. You can do whatever you want to do with it. It is a short wig, obviously. However, it is still versatile. And obviously, as you can see yourself, it's curled. Now, like, this is me just doing this with my hands, literally just throwing it back. Now, so what you could do is grab bobby pins, or kirbies as I call them in Scotland. I believe America you call them bobby pins. Whatever you call them, those little grippers, you can start to pin bits of this up. Now, it already has these curls. It is a synthetic wig. It's made of Modacrylic. Now, it looks like it's pinned up and quite fancy. I would wear the wig pinned back like this on a day-to-day basis as well. Obviously you don't have to, you can wear it down. It does have these gorgeous kind of curls. Now the front, the kind of bangs on it, the fringe part, It is long, so it's kind of chin length. If you want to have that cut, you can. However, like for tying back and the likes, I mean, if I come closer, that is just so natural. The hairline on this, it is so natural. The cap size is average on this, and I would say my head is probably the small size of average. I'm not petite, I'm a kind of smaller size, smaller end of the average range, and this is gorgeous on me. It's gorgeous in that comfort wise, it is phenomenal. So this shade is gorgeous, I do love this shade. Now the amazing Erin actually sent me 3 wigs to try, she did, and she chose the colours. Good job, Erin, because this is a shade that I don't know if I would have chosen, but I love it. The other two wigs that I'm going to be reviewing today for you guys as well, they also are shades I would definitely not have chosen, and from now on I will be choosing because I love them. Anyway, so this is it. So the front kind of bangs are like so, and they're quite straight. What I did do is I have not touched any of the rest of this style wise. These are quite straight. What I did do with this, I will show you, is I used this Ellen Wille. Don't know if you can see it, come on, focus. Ellen Wille styling wet gel formulated for synthetic hair. So I used a wee bit of this and literally just put it through here. Now it still feels incredibly soft. That gel is obviously made for synthetic hair. It is perfect for this. It's not gel as in it doesn't give you a wet look or like what I imagine certainly when I thought of gel. It is really, really beautiful. So yeah, that's because I like the front like this. If you have a wee look in the brochure, the girl who's wearing this wig, who is absolutely stunning, she, oh, look how gorgeous the catalogue is. Hair Society. Honestly, the Hair Society collection is such an exciting collection. I'm really excited by it. You guys who know me know that I do constantly talk about, like, anyone who knows me in person or has ever seen me discuss wigs, I talk about, oh, it's my favourite brand and that's my favourite brand. And I was talking about another brand saying it's my favourite brand. And do you know the thing that's so exciting is that, you know, there's so much space in the market for everybody. Everybody looks for different things in a wig. The Ellen Wille, you know, this collection that I now have tried and have early before it comes out in the US, because I'm so lucky and so privileged and honoured. You know, this collection for people with total hair loss, I'm going to show you the inside of the cap. I have said obviously it is fully hand tied. It's amazing, it's so incredible. Now the girl in the catalogue, who is absolutely beautiful, this is her. She's gorgeous. Now you can see with the charisma what she has done. She has the kind of bangs, front fringe part here. All, sorry, I'm trying to get it so the gloss isn't reflecting off the light too much on the page. So you can see what she's done with this here. She's gorgeous. So she has that kind of back. And you know, you can do what you like with it. You can have it all like that. For me personally, my kind of style is that this is versatile, that's the other thing. And I like to wear it down. Because you have this monofilament top, you can actually change that parting around. It does look like your skin is showing through, as you can see. And like for me, I've kind of just left it the middle parting, but the front I have pulled to the side. That's the style that I kind of like to have this in, but it's so versatile, and that's the thing, you can change it to how you want to have it. This monofilament parting basically means all the hair at each of these parts is coming up. You can change this if you like to have a kind of side parting, then yes you can. Look how natural that looks. You can have middle, you can have right, you can switch it up, do whatever you like to do. Obviously, the fact I have said as well, obviously you have this kind of lace. I mean, you can tuck that behind your ears. There's so much you can do, it's so natural. You have this lace front. The lace front on this is absolutely incredible. Now, what I've done is I've left this. I am going to trim the lace slightly. It does have the extended lace front. So what I will be doing with this, I will trim it ever so slightly, but you know, you don't have to. You can do as you please. It is so super, super natural. It's a ghostie. It's so natural. It's amazing. Okay, so there we go. That's it, just kind of middle. This shade, this Tobacco Rooted, is beautiful. It is very much a kind of brown with so many different coloured highlights, foil type look through it. It has some cool toned blonde through it. It does have some reddish tones through it as well. It's really, really gorgeous, and I think it'd be very flattering for the majority of people, whether you are kind of cool toned skin or yellow toned skin. My skin is very, very fair just now. I have kind of yellow toned skin, so when I tan I do go really quite dark, but at the moment I'm in Scotland, guys. I'm in Scotland and it is cold and the weather is not the best, so I'm really, really fair. But the thing I love about this, the fact it does have the kind of cooler blonde but also has some warmer highlights, and it's got that brown base, I just think that it will suit most skin colouring anyway, regardless of colour. That's not really that big a deal, because this is just to show you, this is the Tobacco Rooted. However, obviously this does come in a whole host of shades, so guys, like, you choose what colour suits yourself. I'm just saying that I particularly love this. It's a shade I've not had before, and I do actually really love the Ellen Wille shades, like the sand rooted, the dark sand rooted, all the different shades that you get. Like when you get ones that have got these highlights and these roots, it's just so, so natural in appearance. What I am going to do for you gorgeous people out there, I am going to do a wee kind of turn just to let you see this wig. Now obviously, depending on how you're wearing this, depends on how it's going to look. But so for a lot of people, you might want to just have it kind of back. I've obviously pulled that super straight rather than the kind of slight kink it has at the bottom. Yeah, so anyway, this is how I like to wear it. So let me just turn and show you density wise on this wig. I would say it is just lovely. It does look like it's more dense than it feels. It does feel quite light because you have that fully hand tied cap, which is just incredible. Let me turn and show you this wig. So this is me straight on. Hi guys. So let me just turn and let you see the left hand side, which as you're looking at it, it'll look right, but this is the kind of left hand side of the actual wig. Okay, so let me do a wee turn for you guys. So we have, let me see, can you see? Am I focusing? Am I too bright? Are the colours bonkers? This is the left hand side of the wig as I obviously am wearing it. Focus. Okay, so let me do a wee turn here. So I've turned that light down because I think my lighting was a wee bit bright. So this is the left hand side of the wig, so from side on. Obviously you can scrunch this as much as you want. It does have these curls. They're so, so pretty. I just think it's such a pretty wig. Depending how you mess around with it, depends on how curly it's going to kind of look. Okay, so I'm just going to do a wee bit of a turn. So this is the left hand side. Obviously depending on how you sweep this here, depends on how it's going to look and what you do with it. Obviously you can have it all kind of just kept super curly, or you can pull that straight as I have. It is versatile like that, which is really incredible. It's the back. Let me show you the right hand side, guys. So the right hand side, obviously I've got it kind of pulled over, so I'm kind of left parting ish. So there we go, guys. I hope that kind of worked. So yeah, it's a really, really beautiful hairpiece, and obviously, like, if you want to cut bangs into it, have them cut in, obviously you can do that. Personally, I wouldn't, because I just want to, but that's just me and my style. Yeah. And plus, look at the lace front. I just, honestly, it's so natural. It's amazing. I'm taking this off just now, guys. Have a tattoo on my head. I have alopecia. I have no hair. So for any of you who don't know me, hi, I'm Michelle and I have alopecia. So this is the hair. Okay. So beautiful. Honestly, it's amazing. So let me just turn it around. That's a better idea. Should have done this in the first place. So yeah. Now, what I always wondered in the past was, can you brush a curly wig? Can you? Should you? Now, the answer to this with this one here, can't speak for all wigs. This is really super soft fibre, and yes, so like I do brush it at the end of the day, and obviously you don't want any kind of knotting getting into that. Now, as you can see there, you might look at that and go, Michelle, you've just brushed out all those beautiful curls, and I want a wig that's going to stay curly. Now, the benefit of the synthetic and the fact this is Modacrylic, see when you wash this hair, see no matter what you actually do with it as you're wearing it, when you wash this, it's going to return to style because acrylic fibre has a memory. So it's going to return straight back to how it was. What I actually do though, I'll show you when I'm finished, how I get the curl straight back without having to just go ahead and wash it. Okay, inside of this cap, this is the thing that if you have total hair loss and you want a synthetic wig, I have generally, obviously I know you can get synthetic wigs out there, lots of brands do make synthetic wigs with a fully hand tied cap, and I think that's incredible. The Hair Society range, it's top notch for how this is. So we have the fully hand tied cap, so this is the kind of on your mesh here, this is your hand tied section here, so the full things like that, so you don't have any wefts. Now for me, a fully hand tied cap is my number one choice in any cap on a wig. I would always opt for fully hand tied. It doesn't mean it's the right choice, it doesn't mean it's the best choice. For me, having total hair loss, personally I also have eczema and a very sensitive scalp, so for me, hand tied cap. Some people will say, you know, oh no, the hand tied's too warm. The reason that you get wefts in some wigs, like the strips around the back, the wefting, is to allow air to circulate and keep your heads cool. And some people will say, I want that for the summer because I just, this is too hot. For me, the wefting, personally, with my skin and my eczema, the wefting can bother me at times, it can irritate me, and I find it a bit of a struggle. And because I'm scratching and all this so much, actually, for me, it ends up making my head more uncomfortable and too warm. So I do find this cooler. And what I do is I wear a bamboo wig liner if I'm too hot to keep my head cool underneath my wig. So anyway, let's talk wig cap. So we have this section here. Your hand tied, so this is over here, this whole section here and at the back, so it's lovely, no wefts, there you go, you can see my wee finger going through. Now the other thing about this, if you do style your wigs like me, I mean as far as I'm concerned, in a box this is a wig, on my head this is my hair, so I treat it as such. Obviously I can't use heated appliances on this particular synthetic here, can't use that. However, look, when you separate this, what the other good thing about hand tied, when you separate it you will see skin, you will see your scalp no matter where you separate that because it is hand tied. So if you're going to style it and tie it up, do anything with it, you don't actually have to be too worried. You don't need to be thinking, oh my goodness, like you're going to see a weft. Well, you won't because there are none. It's lovely, it's so beautiful, it's so comfortable, so luxurious. And the way that it's kind of made as well, with this kind of elastic, almost elasticated type section, although hand tied, it just allows it to mould and conform to the shape of your head, which is really, really special. At the back, we have the tag, Ellen Wille here, and it does state, obviously, it's Modacrylic fibre. This section here along the nape of your neck, this is extremely soft felt, really, really soft. It's lovely. It does not itch me at all. The only thing, I probably will take this tag off because I tend to remove tags in my wigs a lot of the time. Although having said that, having worn this, normally I would wear a bamboo cap under my wig for comfort and for cooling. I've not got one on under this when I'm wearing this because it's super comfortable. Now to adjust the size, if you want to bring it in any, you can adjust with these Velcro tighteners here, which I like the Velcro. So you have that if you want to tighten it up any. If you obviously want it to be looser and you don't want any tightening around here at all, you don't need it, then that's fine because that kind of felt material goes right there, so you can actually have them super loose. You don't really need to tighten them at all whatsoever. Now, this is an average size cap, okay? So I would say wearing it, like, I'm probably smaller size of average, and it's perfect on me. So it would be, you know, I'd say that's fine. Obviously, you have a good amount of stretch in this, although it's hand tied. It's really, really great. Does conform to the kind of shape of your heads, because as you know, like, we all have different shaped heads. I would not have maybe necessarily known how different shaped heads you can have till I lost my hair and saw my actual wee bald head. So yeah, everybody is different, and that's what's really good about this, you know, it's really, really good. Now, around the back here, these are the kind of ear tabs here, sorry, not the back, the kind of ear tabs here. These are actually silicone, kind of non-slip, which is really good for total hair loss. That is just totally grips your skin. And if you want, for added security, you could apply some wig tape along here, double-sided wig tape, if you wanted to. I don't have to. It grips amazingly, so, so good. Now, this whole section is your monofilament top, which runs right across here. So you can change your parting anywhere within that. Obviously, you've got hand tied anyway. This is such a huge monofilament top, really, like, huge, like, it goes right round here on me, this monofilament top. So it's a really, really big monofilament. What this has as well, and I've not trimmed it yet because I wanted to show you guys, it does have an extended lace front on it. So it comes slightly further than where all the lace is. It looks like an actual hairline I've showed you on already. This cap in the Hair Society range, there are slightly different versions of caps. On this Charisma, on this style, this is just like a 10 out of 10 for me. I love it. Obviously, for me, I love hand tied. For me, it's comfortable. For me, it's my favourite. I love that the ear tabs are silicone. I love that they're silicone rather than felt for that security, especially when you have a lace front. If you're wanting to be tying your hair up or anything, it's gripping there. It's not going to kind of keep coming back or anything, like, as you're styling it. I love that. I love it. If you are somebody who loves wefts on your wig, then this doesn't have any. It's fully hand tied. Now, cost wise, this isn't actually launched yet. So in the US, if you are looking at this gorgeous, gorgeous hair, then it will be out soon. It should be out kind of May time. So I don't know what the cost actually is at present. However, I believe these are available in the UK at the moment. What I'm going to do, I will link to the Ellen Wille US site in the description bar down below. I will also link to the Ellen Wille Europe site. But this came to me from Ellen Wille US before launch for me to trial, because Erin wants to know what I thought of it as somebody with total hair loss. What do I think of this? Because this cap, this range, Hair Society, have been designed for people with total hair loss in mind. So people like me. So I love when a company will come to me and say, hey, you're the kind of person that we want and to know. This is that our product's been made for people like yourself. Can you let us know what you think? Because that shows that they really, really care. So Erin wanted some feedback on that, and the feedback is that this is amazing. Really amazing. I really, really love it. The hand tied cap is always going to be a winner for me personally. Ellen Wille is a brand. I think it's a very, very good brand. Very, very good. This is so different from any Ellen Wille product I have ever tried in the past. I have never tried an Ellen Wille like this. The only thing, if you want me to pick holes in everything, because I always like to be totally 100% honest and everything, cap size, perfect. Perfect. The way it's constructed as well, I have tried other brands fully hand tied, which I love, but I found a couple of times they're slightly big for me because I am the smaller end of average. The way this is constructed, it does conform amazingly right across this section from right round. I like the way that this hand tied is constructed. I do. I really love it. I love the silicone ear tabs, another big bonus. So hand tied bonus, monofilament top bonus, lace front bonus, silicone ear tabs, super bonus. Form, size, the way it's made, for me, yeah, that's kind of everything I look for in a wig cap. So yeah, it's pretty amazing. If you want me to pick holes, as I said, if you want to know any negatives, I wouldn't particularly say for me there are negatives. If you're somebody, now this is not double monofilament, it's monofilament, so all these wee knots are coming through here. For me, that can be a real big issue sometimes, because sometimes this is quite rough and it can irritate my scalp. This doesn't irritate my scalp. I do sometimes prefer a double monofilament, however, with the way this cap's constructed and everything, and when you actually feel it, it's not too rough, it's not too rough, and the silicone keeps that nice and secure. The only thing, if you want me to try and find a negative, it's so hard, I was racking my brain because I thought, I always like to give positives. Now for this, there's pretty much everything positive, and I like to give negatives. The only, just to be honest, like from my point of view, obviously cap construction is a very personal thing. We don't all look for the same thing in a wig. We're not all total hair loss. We're not all, you know, there are different things. Everybody has their own preference. So there's no right, there's no wrong. It's what's right for you. Now for me, this is everything I look for in a wig, and it gives the most natural appearance, I believe. So if you don't, like, everyone that I know knows I've got alopecia. People I don't know that I've got alopecia. But, you know, not everybody tells everyone that. So if you're looking for a wig that's supernatural, and you don't want people to know that you're wearing a wig or that you have hair loss, this hair society style, this here, I would recommend. It's really worth going for, because people will not be able to tell. For added security, the only thing, if I'm looking to try and pick a hole in anything, the only thing I would do to change this cap construction, I would maybe run a couple of silicone strips either around here, just for added security again, or a wee silicone strip band over here. This is me really nitpicking. I had to try and think what I could pick holes in for this. Maybe a silicone part at the back here, just because it's the only thing I could think of that would improve this at all. It took me a long time to think. However, I have a silicone sheet, which is, you know, made for cutting strips and adding into a wig, so I could cut strips and stitch them onto my cap if I want to personalise that a bit more and to give a wee bit of added security. Being honest though, wearing this wig, it doesn't really need it. This is me just trying to find something that I think could be improved upon. It's the only thing I could think of. Now, obviously, if you're somebody who likes a wefted wig, this is not wefted, this is fully hand tied. If you want your wig to look as natural as possible, this for me is the best cap to look natural. What I did say to you guys was, obviously I brushed that. Now the acrylic always returns when washed back to its original kind of state. Now I'm brushing this. A lot of people might be like, why are you brushing it? It's curly, what are you doing? It's been brushed at the end of me wearing it each time I've worn it. And it does go back to curly, because what I actually do, so you can see it's kind of trying to get itself back to it already with its memory. Now, I could just pop a bit of just cold water in my hands and scrunch what I actually do. Now, this is just me, but my recommendation, rather than that, what I tend to do, well, I would maybe do that through the day. I don't brush it a lot through the day, to be honest. I was just wanting to show you guys. I do always brush the end of the day because I want this to stay in good condition. I don't want it to get knotted because I've not brushed it and looked after it. So don't be frightened. It's the amazing quality synthetic fibre that Ellen Wille produce. I do actually use this Ellen Wille hair tip liquids. I use this on my wigs. Now this has been formulated for human and for synthetic hair. So what I do is, like a serum, I get a tiny bit. She wants it to go super greasy, like that amount, tiny, like a cent or a penny type size. I rub it in my hands so you don't even see it anymore. I literally put it through the ends. It is hair tip liquid, and it just helps those ends stops them becoming quite so friable, and you know how you can get that way with wigs sometimes. So it also helps rejuvenate those curls that I have kind of brushed out. But at the same time, using that Ellen Wille hair tip liquid just gives, you're kind of doing a two-in-one. You're getting your curls back and you're treating your wig. So yeah, a wee bit of cold, if I put cold water in this, it's going to all revert straight back to the style it came in as I got it. For me, I'm going to wear this just like so for today. So guys, I hope this was an okay review for you. I appreciate that it is quite a long review. I know it's a long review because I talk a lot. However, I kind of feel like, as I've already said, in a box, this is a wig. So when I get this and it comes in the gorgeous Hair Society box, it's a wig. As soon as I put that onto my head, it's my hair. As far as I'm concerned, it's my hair. It doesn't grow out my head, but it's on my head. It's my hair. Same as if I had hair and I chose to get a weave or anything like that, I consider it my hair. So yeah, basically my review might be longer than what a lot of people would review for a wig. However, what I will do as well is I'm going to write a wee blog piece on the Hair Society, and I will link in my blog site in the description bar down below. My blog site is https://baldbarbie.com. That's my site. So if you want to follow me and hear all things I have to say and opinions on things, please do. I really, really like this. Now, I want to just be 100% honest with you guys. I received these three wigs and I had said, yeah, I'm going to review them. I kind of thought I was going to review them and send them back to Ellen Wille US, was what I had thought. Now, when I received them, I had a note from Erin Fortune, who is honestly like so super kind. And she said, from Ellen Wille US, here are your complimentary wigs. And I was like, what? What? So I haven't paid for these. I was given these to review and give an honest review. They want an honest review. But I have received this wig and I did not pay for this wig. However, I'm only telling you guys this to be totally transparent and to be totally honest. I think that's so important. That doesn't change my opinion on anything. You know, like, if I received a wig and didn't pay for it and did not like it, I would say, in a nice way, you know, it's not my favourite, it's not beneficial for me for these reasons. The wigs that Erin chose to send for me, I have three, one human hair and two synthetic. The two synthetic Hair Society wigs are phenomenal. Now, in regards to human hair or synthetic, there are pros and cons to each. I will do a separate video on that. However, you cannot heat style this. You cannot use heated appliances in this. So if you were thinking you want to use heated appliances on it, you cannot. You will melt it. So yeah, you can't do that. However, if you were wanting a totally straight kind of wig like this, there are more in here. I'm actually going to review a kind of bobbed straight wig anyway, which is amazing. This is secret until May 2017, I believe, and I so want to open it and show you all everything. All I can say, guys, is I think you might all be blown away. If you have total hair loss, if you have alopecia universalis, if you have alopecia totalis, if you have lost all of your hair, if you have androgen effluvium, you've lost all your hair post chemotherapy treatment, I think that you will be impressed with this. Honestly, it's really revolutionary. So thank you, Ellen Wille, for producing something so revolutionary. It's really, really great. It's really great. It's so exciting. And I'm so honoured and so privileged to have the opportunity to review such gorgeous hair. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to upload this. I'm actually about to go out, so I'm going out wearing this. And when I come home, I am going to do a review of another two and get them uploaded as well. So guys, I hope this review's been okay. I am aware of the fact it's taken half an hour. I want to be thorough, I want to cover everything. I like to talk about cap construction. If you are new to the world of wigs, then I don't want to bamboozle everybody. So I will do a video describing different cap types. But I did show you how this is. You guys have seen me in my bald and my natural state. The one thing I would say doing this video, when I said at the start, oh, you know, like you can obviously get bobby pins and you can pin that up and you can do this and you can do that. I didn't even like try doing all this to look and see how it looked already. And then when I did it at the start of this video, I thought, oh, I actually like that idea. So I may do that and go out. Another thing I would like to kind of give credit to Ellen Wille for, this is a conversation I had with a friend lately. Now, obviously everyone's preference and style and whatever is different, otherwise there would only be one type of wig and it would one haircut and everyone in the world would have it. We all like different things. For me, on any wig that is kind of chin length, bobbed, I have this thing whereby I am constantly looking at these wigs and going, oh, it's gorgeous. Why do they cut bangs into it? Why do they cut a fringe? Why are there layers that are here? Don't get me wrong, I know that that's the kind of stylish thing and loads of people love that. I do like it. I'm not saying I don't like it. It irritates me though when they're on a wig, because I'm kind of like, if every wig had the bangs long, the fringe, the front of the wig long and chin length like the rest, if I want, I can go and get it cut. I can get it layered. However, when it comes with these shorter bangs at the front, the shorter layers at the front, I can't grow them because it's a wig. I can't grow them. And you know, I like to have length around my face. My face, guys, it's quite, I mean, I have a lot of makeup on. If you see me in my natural state, I have quite a big face. I do have quite a big face. Now, for me, what suits me is to have layers around the front of my face. So in a long wig, if you ever see me wearing a long wig, you will generally see me with layers around here. And if you see me in a short wig, it's always longer at the front with layers around here, kind of chin length, and then it'll maybe come up at the back. That's just personal preference. But yeah, so basically what I'm saying, Ellen Wille, thank you, because you did not cut short bangs into the front of this. Yeah, that's all. So guys, I'm going to go because I could actually sit here and talk to you all day. I would like to say thank you to Ellen Wille US. Thank you so very much for giving me the opportunity to review these wigs. You know, even the opportunity to try these and review these for you guys and for everyone out there who's watching this, thank you. So for the opportunity to do this is massive within itself. I would have done that and sent these hair pieces back to you guys, absolutely no problem. The fact that you've actually given me these and I am actually getting to wear them every day, and I have had them on a wee bit before I've done the review to see how they go, you know, I am so grateful and thank you. Anybody out there who wears wigs, if you want more information than I have given or than I have shown, please leave a comment down below. Any constructive criticism is fine and it is good with me. I am so happy for anyone to say, right, Michelle, I would have preferred you did this, I would like you to do that, next wig review, I want you to cover this, I want you to cover that. That's good, that's constructive feedback, you know, and I will work on that, because at the end of the day, my rationale and my reasoning for doing these things is purely to be honest and give a review. I want to be honest, I want to give reviews. I would actually just like to say, guys, basically, I love this cap construction so much, to the extent that I am going to buy one of these. I'm going to buy a Hair Society wig. I'm going to buy one with my own money. I am, because I do love them. That is how much I do love them. If I didn't love them, I wouldn't obviously do that. Yeah. So, yeah. So that's that. I want to get more wig reviews onto my own channel here. And you know, guys, buy from who you want to buy from. What I will do, these are actually already on sale in the United Kingdom. So for anybody who is UK, what I'm going to do is link in a company that I really, really love. And I know the owner, Carly Barrett, is amazing. The company is called Alicance Hair Loss Solutions. So I am not being paid to recommend her. I'm not getting anything for recommending her. I'm just saying I think she's amazing. I know that she does stock these already, so if you're UK, I'm going to link this in the description bar. What I am going to do is do a link to Ellen Wille US down below, so for all of you gorgeous people in the USA, then yeah, I'm going to do a wee link down to Ellen Wille US. What I will do is I will speak to Erin and Robert, Ellen Wille US guys, and I will find out if there are any links that they specifically want added below, and I can add those if there are any particular sellers they recommend anywhere in particular to buy it. So yeah, Ellen Wille US, you guys are incredible. I apologize for my British teeth, cause yeah, I know that American people, you guys in the US, tend to always have gorgeous teeth, because every time I meet anyone from the US, or I've been in the US and met people, or like anyone, I kind of like, wow, you all have gorgeous teeth. So yeah, sorry, but British teeth, oh, that's not offensive to anybody who also lives in Great Britain, it's just a joke. Anyway guys, see y'all soon, bye!